Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about how to prevent broken access control vulnerabilities. So let's get started. Broken access control is a highly ranked OWASP-listed vulnerability rated to happen occasionally, has moderate exploitability, and has extremely deeper and harmful impacts. Additionally, broken access control is a leading factor in data breaches and leaks, which often result in huge penalties, business reputation loss, and customer information exposure to fraudsters. It is therefore essential to address these vulnerabilities before attackers take advantage of them, and in general, establish an access control policy. Following is the list of best practices and tools commonly used to prevent broken access control vulnerability attacks. Following are some best practices that security teams can adopt to prevent broken access control. Deny by default. With access control, a good rule of thumb is to start with the minimum required privileged functions. For example, by default, every application's user should be denied access to application resources, with only a legitimate user getting permissions to view, access, and modify them. In addition, security teams should remove admin rights and other elevated privileges, reducing the scope of impact once an attacker obtains a user's credentials. Session management should also be performed using just-in-time access, to eliminate the need for persistent privileges that hackers can quickly obtain. Central interface for application-wide access controls. Every organization needs a standard method to evaluate the effectiveness of access control decisions. It is therefore essential to have a central, managed interface to document the access control schemes used and aid in the design of a framework used to test the success of established access control mechanisms. Handle access controls at server side. Organizations should only trust server-side authentication and authorization as it applies the same controls to all services, users, and applications. Security teams and developers should develop a template for the separation of duties. For instance, role templates help the server validate requests based on permissions associated with a specific role and not grant access to unauthorized users. Constant testing and auditing of access controls. It is important to make security testing a continuous, consistent process, by continuously testing and auditing access control mechanisms to ensure they work as intended. In addition, efficient testing helps teams identify newer vulnerabilities and flaws as they come up, enhancing the organization's confidence in their implementation of access control. Clean code with binary access controls. Every developer should ensure that their source code includes rules that declare access for every resource at the code level, and the access should be denied by default. It is also important to use secure coding practices to avoid common programming errors that attackers target for privileged access. Enable RBAC. Role-based access control enables organizations to quickly implement access control by grouping users into roles and defining the permissions associated with each role. With RBAC, security teams can reduce the toil of IT support and administration, maximize operational efficiency, and improve compliance through data access management. Enforce record ownership. Organizations should model access controls that associate each record with the account's user ID that performs tasks, rather than allowing users to access, modify, update, or delete any records. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.